Welcome back to another video. My name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress videos for non-techies just like me. And I'm going to share something really neat in this video. It's a new product that just came out, but there was actually lots of clues and hints dropped about this product, and it's called Beaver Themer, and it's from the folks that make Beaver Builder. And if you're not familiar, here is Beaver Builder, and it's actually the page building plugin for WordPress that I am using on my website. So you can see my homepage here. I am using Beaver Builder all throughout my website, and it's one of the most reliable page builders currently available for WordPress, and it's definitely a developer favorite. And so they just came out with a new plugin that is in the very early stages. Now, here's the good news. If you're already a customer and you've purchased a license for Beaver Builder, you can log right in and start using this plugin if you are bold and courageous enough, because it's an alpha. That means it's not even beta. So you have your final version, then your beta version before that, and before that you have the alpha version, which means it's going to have some bugs in it. But this new plugin called Beaver Themer is really, I don't want to be overly dramatic. There's plenty of people already being overly dramatic, but it's kind of hard not to, because it's really changing how you will make WordPress-based websites. Now, if you've had a WordPress website for any length of time, you know that after 6 months or 12 months, you start getting that urge to try a different WordPress theme, because there might be some new updated style in this new WordPress theme, or there's new ways of doing things or new design trends, and you want to keep up with that. You want a good looking website. I mean, who doesn't want a good looking website? So typically what you've done in the past is you would just go and shop around for a new WordPress theme, and you would buy it, and then you'd have to convert all your data across to make it work, and then you'd have to learn a whole new interface and settings panel and all this kind of stuff that is really a barrier to changing out and updating the style of your website. Now, Beaver Themer is going to eliminate that hassle. Well, that's my take on it. If you ask five people, they might give you all a different reason of why this is kind of an amazing thing that they've put out. But if you ask me, it's going to make it so if you went with Beaver Builder and the Beaver Builder theme, that you literally don't need to use another theme for the entire life of your website. Because this new plugin unlocks every area of your website to be designed with Beaver Builder. So let me try to give you an example right now for me. My website, adamprizer.com, it's got my full name on it. About a year ago, I was playing around and I thought, let me just install Beaver Builder and the theme. But I got discouraged and didn't continue and complete this website. Now, this website is not a throwaway website. I'm going to revitalize it. I used to do a lot with it. I haven't done much with it in the last 2 years. All of my effort and energy has gone to WPCrafter.com, not this domain name. But I do want to revitalize it. So I put Beaver Builder in and I put the theme in. Now, this website, mind you, is mostly posts, blog posts with videos, just like my other website, but it's mostly just blog posts with video. Now, if you've used Beaver Builder or any theme, you know that they have these defined ways of how your post is going to look, and you can't really change it at all. Now, obviously, I could use Beaver Builder on each post on my page, each and every post, and I can create something custom. Now, the problem is if I want to change anything, when you do it that way, you have to manually change it on each and every post. Let me show you what I was able to do in about 15 minutes using Beaver Themer. But let me caution you first, I installed this alpha build of Beaver Themer on this website, and that's really not something I would advise someone to do. It's working out fine for me, but if I run into a problem, I'll know how to fix it. I don't recommend it for everybody, but if you're adventurous and kind of have a death wish, then you could try it too. So if you were to go to my website, I'm embarrassed, okay? Don't judge me. I just haven't had the effort and motivation to put into this. this is what a blog post looks like. I don't have a sidebar, so I've got this big ugly title here. I need to play around with the fonts. I've got my video and I've got a little transcript, and it's not that exciting, and it's nothing at all that I'm proud of, and I want to say, hey, go here. Let me show you what I was able to do with Beaver Themer in about 15 minutes. I was able to change the way that posts look from this, every post looking like this, to making every post look like this. So I've got the featured image in the background, but it's kind of faint and there's some opacity over it. I've got this big title right here, my image, and then here's the video. It's a little larger. I lifted it up with some negative margin, so there's this overlapping effect. And then I lifted it off the page a little bit with a box shadow. And then when you scroll down, I have some of the elements in the post. I don't really put enough content in these posts. This is actually a very old post. Now, do you see how I went from this, and there was really no way to change it without digging into some code, and I've got zero interest in doing that. There is no way to change it from this to this on a global level without this thing called Beaver Themer. So what it's going to allow you to do is to change things on a global basis. So if you have blogs or anything which is called a custom post type, if you have any custom post types, you can design the most beautiful and gorgeous pages. Now, if you don't know what a custom post type is, that's okay. A blog post is called, I guess, a normal post. And then they have something called custom post types. And a good example of custom post types is when you say, for example, you go to a very popular podcaster's website, and then there's a menu link that says podcasts, and you click on it and it shows like a list of all their podcasts, and you can click on the page and you can listen to the podcast and you can see some of the show notes and all that. Well, those are custom post types more times than not. Same thing if you say went to a website that had cars for sale and they showed all these listings and you would click on a listing and then it would show you information about a car. Those are custom post types. So you can use this Beaver Themer to be able to do powerful things like that in WordPress. Now, I have a news flash for you. This is nothing new. There's already a tool that's been able to do this for a while. And if you're a coder and you like to dig into it, you will have no problem doing this. And you've never had a problem doing this. But see, the difference with this is you and me, the people who don't want to learn how to code everything, can do this very, very easily using this new tool. So here is the back end of the website. I usually don't show people the back end of this website, but that's okay. Here we are. So if you already have Beaver Builder, you're used to having an option here that says templates. Well, they've renamed it to Builder. Now, all of this can change because it's just an alpha and there's little tweaks here that they're going to change. Heck, they might even change the name, but I hope they don't. So you can go here and there's this new option called theme layouts. If you have the plugin installed, you'll have this theme layouts right here. And so here is what I created. Let me just click on it real quick. I called it single post. Now let me show you what it looks like when you click on edit theme layout. I have it already open right here. So this is not editing that one post. This is the general template. So when you see right here my title, when I click on it, it's actually not my title. It's pulling it from the post title for the blog post. So we're creating this global template, this global style that I can apply to as many or as few blog posts as I choose. And what they've essentially done is they've taken your typical blog post and they've reduced it to all the little elements, and you can drag and drop and put those wherever the heck you want to put those in order to build the most beautiful blog post layout of what you want. Now, I said that this will allow you to keep Beaver Builder forever and not have any desire to change themes. And the reason is, you know, so say I wanted to not have this video so big. Well, I can come here, make that change, and that change goes globally across all of my blog posts that I've assigned this template to. So remember in the beginning, I said you can do this now, essentially, but you'd have to do it on a post-by-post basis. And if you wanted to make one change, you'd have to change it on every single post. And it's just not practical and not advisable. But this is just mind-boggling. So right here, I've got the author image, the author name, a link of the amount of comments that I have. And if I wanted to move this someplace else, I can just do it the way you would normally do it with Beaver Builder. Now for me, this is kind of a game changer, and that's such an overly used phrase, but it really is, because now I can have my blog posts look however I want and change them globally whenever I want. So if I wanted to remove my image from all of the blog posts I have this template on, all I have to do is click this X and it goes away from all of them. That is some powerful stuff right there, but that is not where it ends. You can use this new tool on any of these custom post types. Now, you still might not be familiar with custom post types, and that's okay. Let me log in right here and go back to theme layouts. So you see another one right here that says lesson. Now I'm using, as you can see, Lifter LMS. I'm still using it. I'm still using the product and it's been working fine for me. And I do have the paid version, but if you've used, say in this example, a learning management system and you create a lesson, well, that plugin's gonna have its own lesson design, right? The video goes where they want the video. The syllabus goes where they want the syllabus. The previous and next links to the next lessons goes where they want that. The overall design is how they want it. But with a tool like Beaver Themer, you can totally change that entire lesson layout and have it be exactly how you want it just using this one tool. In fact, I did that. I created a lesson template and it's the same thing right here. I was just playing around with it and I'm feeling a little adventurous. Let's see what happens when I click on view theme layout right there. So it's going to show me this layout of what I designed right here. Oops, let me pause that. So I've designed this new lesson layout and I like this big video area right here, and you can scroll down and it's kind of ugly. I'm still playing around with it, but I've got my lesson title. I've got my previous lesson button right here and all that, course projects, course outline. So you can see the power of this. If you've used Lifter LMS, you know it does not look like this. If you want it to look like this, you're going to have to go and hire a coder to do it for you. But with a tool like Beaver Themer, you don't have to do that. If you are comfortable using Beaver Builder and it is so easy and intuitive to use, then you can globally change the lesson layout for all of your lessons. Now that is really just one example of what you're able to do with this. You can literally redesign any page that WordPress generates. Now, if you're familiar with WordPress, they have something called archive pages, 404 pages, pages for your categories, your tags, all of it. You have all these different pages that WordPress generates that before you couldn't really change without modifying code. It was whatever your theme wanted it to look like, and that's just what you had to live with. But now that is different. So Beaver Themer is in alpha stage. It's probably, my guess is going to take 4 to 6 months to get out of alpha to be a full release. They are going to charge for it. There's going to be an additional cost for it, and they should, because it's so stinking powerful and it's really going to change the way we build websites. Now, some nice things about what this does. It will work with any theme that you could throw at it. This is pretty amazing. I haven't tried it outside of the Beaver Builder theme, but I might try it on my other website, which is not the Beaver Builder theme. And so you can use this on any theme available. Now there's some additional features that will only work on certain themes. So now you're going to be able to use this Beaver Themer to design custom headers in Beaver Builder and footers in Beaver Builder. And that's going to work in the Beaver Builder theme, the Genesis themes, and one of my favorite themes, the GeneratePress theme. All three awesome themes. And I'm sure over time they're going to be adding support for other themes as well. But off the bat, you're getting compatibility. And that's just a header and footer thing. So if you don't care about the header and footer, I do actually. I want to redesign everything on this site. New fonts, new header, everything, probably new logo. I want to do the whole nine yards with it. But it's nice to know that the Beaver Themer will work with any theme. But if you want those custom headers and footers, you're going to need to use just one of their supported themes. Now, here's what you can expect from me. I know I didn't go into a lot of detail in this video of actually using it. There's already some videos out on actually using it. And this video hasn't been about actually using it. It's about how I just used it and I'm very impressed and I haven't run into any problems with it and why you might want to think about using this product as well. Now, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to show you some advanced things with this, okay? There's some really advanced things that I didn't touch on in this video about custom post types, creating custom post types for yourself, about adding something called custom fields, which is really the developer power behind this thing. I really didn't get into that, but I'm going to make videos on that stuff, and you can expect that maybe a video each week. What I'll do is in the pinned comment section down below, I will put links to every video that I make about Beaver Themer. Also, if you are currently enrolled in my course, Beaver Builder Essentials, I'm going to create a whole new module and cover every aspect of Beaver Themer, and there's going to be advanced stuff in there. I'll probably put some templates for blog posts and things like that in there just to add value to that course. If you're already enrolled into the course, if you have not seen the Beaver Builder Essentials course, I'll have a link to that down below. And also, if you don't have Beaver Builder and you'd like to see some more information on that, I have a link down below to that. This is an exciting new twist in using WordPress, and I think this might go down as one of the biggest product releases for WordPress for 2017. Because you made it to the end of the video, I have a free gift for you. But before I talk about that, I want to ask you to do something for me. If you could give this video a thumbs up down below, that would really help me out. If you're not subscribed to the channel, go ahead and click on that subscribe button and become a subscriber and support this channel. And if you'd like YouTube to notify you when I upload new videos, there's a little bell next to that subscribe button. You can click on that and set that up as well. If you have any questions or a comment about this video, I'd love to answer it. There's a comment section down below. All you have to do is put in your question or comment. I respond to every single one. Hey, I made a course just for you, and it's called The 3 Steps to WordPress Success, and I want to give this to you. If you'd like to enroll in this course, there's a button right here off to the right. You can go ahead and click on that, enroll as a student, and that's just my way of saying thank you for supporting me and making it to the end of this video. I make them just for you.